Hello guys, my new sleeping bag just arrived from One Piece Viking 600. I read about it online that it was a good one, I needed a down sleeping bag for the winter. So I bought this one. And I thought I'm gonna share the moment that I unpack for the first time. As you can see, it's still taken. It's two sleeping bags in here. What I noticed is actually a very big pack. Bigger than I expected, but I don't think they are compressed. Number one. That's probably a gift. Peanuts. And number two. We're gonna start with number one. So they're both the same. One is supposed to be left and right zip, so you can connect them. It's a Viking 600, so as you can see, they can be really compressed. That's why, as you can see in my previous videos, I had a Ice Bjørnøya, and it's a synthetic one. Of course, that's bigger, not so compressible. That's why I thought I have to find a more compressible sleeping bag. Let's see how this one is. So that's that one. Oh, we even have the compression bag here. That's easy to have the addition as well. You see, you can really compress it, and I suppose it fits in this bag. We're gonna try that later. So that's the sleeping bag. Put this on the side a little bit. First thing I noticed is that it's feels more synthetic, but it's not so thin actually. Feels pretty good. Like with every down sleeping bag, you have to let it lay a little bit before you sleep in it, so it can have the time to inflate. Zipper is on this side, maybe I should flip it around. A zipper on the bottom. Yeah. I have two hooks to hang it up. Discovering here by myself, they never saw the sleeping bag, so I hang it up here, I suppose. If you don't use it. Some people say that's not good because then the down will sink down after a while, and they say just stuff it in this big stuff sack and let it lay. Others say you have to hang it up, but I don't know what's best. I think it's best that you just let it lay in this one, and it makes a little bit sense that it sinks down. So zipper on the feet. You see it really start inflating very well. And here you can see the temperature ratings. 600 queen duck down. Goose down is better of course, but yeah. If you see the temperature ratings, for me good for using in 3 seasons. In the winter you would maybe need more. Depending on, this is for women, this is for men. In Norway winters can be colder. I think for most people this will be sufficient. That First thing I noticed that I like is that many sleeping bags have an issue if you close the zipper that will get in between. What I notice here is that there's a strap on here that prevents this from getting between the zipper. And on this side it's just the same. It's a little less noticeable, but it's a harder material. So you can easily, without getting it in between. So I would say that's a plus. Seems like you have a pocket here. Probably your phone or electronic equipment that you need to keep on. Well, really, really, really looks good quality. I have to say that. I think they did a good job. As you can see, it's pretty wide. I don't remember exactly, but I thought it was 80 wide. You can have them on wider. But I think the one I ordered is normal standard. Made by One Piece. Another thing I like about it, here stands the quality control. And it's the bags are made in Czechia, but the down is put in by Karl Sluka in Germany. And the last guy who do the control put his name on here. FR Lex. Probably Frank Lex or something. Frankenstein Lex, I don't know. So yeah, that's that one. It's really getting thicker. I think you're gonna try to jump into this one and see what it feels like. First open it. It's really a spacey sleeping bag, yes. And what I feel also, what I notice, is that the bottom is filled very good with for the feet. It's thicker here. And, so I put all the clothes on for the sleeping bag. Always watch out with sharp pieces on my pants. So I'm gonna try the sleeping bag now. You can see there's also a flap here, a piece that goes over the zipper, and what I was just thinking about. The zipper is open here on the outside, and on the inside there goes something over. So I think that's supposed to be good. Feels comfortable, of course, it's down. I'm gonna try not to fall asleep, otherwise the video gonna be too long. Let me see. As you can see here on the inside, we have a strap for around your neck. I'm gonna try that one first. It's really compressible very well. I can say that. A little bit for more movability. And then we have one on the outside, which I suppose goes around the hood. Try that one. There's a red and a black cord here. I think probably each of them goes to one side. The black one goes down to the bottom. So probably if you want to tie the bottom more, you do this one. And if you want to tie the hoodie more, probably you do the other one. We're gonna try them both. It's really a smart system with the two colors, I have to say that. As you can see, it's really nice and tight. So, well, I noticed already that I feel the warmth dragged inside the sleeping bag. It's really building up. Of course, I'm laying inside and I'm wearing my clothes, but you can still feel it on my arms that it's warm. I'll open that up again. The other one and this one. It's really a good system. Oh, this is the wrong hand for me. It's, normally if you're right handed you need the zipper on that side. If you're left handed on this side, but I should have taken the other one for testing first. That's because you can connect them both. So as you can see, the zipper goes all the way around to the inside. There's not two metal trousers, or whatever you call them in English. There's one that goes around, oh, that better or worse, I don't know. And then normally you can open them here.
There you go.
Well, this is for, I have no idea. So now you can connect the other one on this one. It's really a good hood. It's also, again, as you can see here, it's warm. This is more. You feel it direct that it's more material in that one. That's really a good system with the two. You can also see if you're in the dark. The one rope is flat and the other is round. So I didn't see that on a sleeping bag before. Yeah, let me look at the inside here. That's what I expected. We have two drawers here. That's for if you want to turn your sleeping bag inside out and hang them up for getting the condensation out. So you have one on this side and you have one on both sides. Especially for if the dry boats. Even if it doesn't feel wet, especially with down, if you feel it, even if it doesn't feel wet and you sleep in it, your condensation will go into the material. And you drying your sleeping bag helps. Even when it's not really wet to the touch. So now this evening I will be sleeping. I was waiting for it. It came in the post now 5 minutes ago. So I actually grabbed the package and I came straight up. I was really excited to look at it. And I thought I have to share this with my friends here. And yeah, really excited. I was happy with the service. Small things really make customers happy, so it's a nice thing. I'm gonna take this with me on the tour. I will be letting you know tomorrow what I thought of it and how the experience was. So I'm gonna be sleeping outside. Yesterday it was snowing. And I think it's gonna be around -5 in the night, something like that. Maybe a little bit colder, maybe warmer. But I'll let you know. Really happy with the sleeping bag. This is number 2, which is obviously the same. So two sleeping bags. I bought these myself, so I'm not sponsored at all by Warmpiece or Hectapertuur, where I bought it online in Norway. I buy it myself, I did a review by myself, so no connections with the company, nothing at all. I own this piece and I make my own I own this piece and I make my own review about it. So I'm gonna close it again. I don't really know what this one is for. If you guys know, let me know. Foufelage. There it goes. I think I have to press it a little bit deeper in. You see, really nothing stuck in between. That's really what I have an issue with if you have a sleeping bag with some synthetic cover. So now we have unsawed this one. Now we're gonna put it in the stuff sack. And this one cannot close, so that one has to hang on this a little bit. There's a bag on the inside of the stuff bag. Thank you for strengthening these. Looks amazing that that one will fit in there, but it has to fit, I think. I really like to start compressing good in the bottom already. Always like to leave the start with the head and end with the feet. Because if you are on the sleeping place, everything is out. Dus dat zal wel random niet voor te zijn.
Hoge kloos hier.
Lessig.
En dat draait om even de smallest possible hier. Dus toen zo je het skip off. Zo, en dan dus de off one side. Other side. Go down, you have to wait a little bit, you have to let the air escape. I'm thinking about... Normally I never compress my sleeping bag so much, because I feel if you do that, you get a rock of a density in your backpack, and it's not really maneuverable. So if you put it in, you cannot press it. So what I often do is, if my backpack is, for example, this wide, I let it go that way and I just press it on the bottom and everything will sink it down. Give the same space. Now I feel like you have a lot of holes everywhere, lost space. But let's say I can go a little bit more, but let's say this is the doable volume you can get it down to. If you see, sleeping bag is 180 long, it's for persons up to 180, so I fit very well in that. Another bag. For me, I can say that it's not heavy. The total weight without the cover is 1110 grams. See it here. So I would say I'm really satisfied until now. Now I can easily fit two of them in my backpack without having an issue. See, I can just one of the smallest sleeping bags I own so far.
Nice.
Check it out and get the follow-up later. I'm gonna look for a place to sleep and test the sleeping bag. So we're up there in the forest. This found is here. That's an anthill. And black woodpecker did really a good job on this one. Morning. As you see, I'm here sleeping I'm here testing the sleeping bag, and I'm happy with it. It really blows, inflates overnight, and it really gives warm air because the air trapped in it is insulation. I really like the hood on this. You don't need the hat at all. It's warm and built enough to keep the hat warm. I connected them two together. So, as you can see, that also works. Now, the temperature is good. I don't know exactly what the temperature was in the night, but I can see that the water around here and the condensation was frozen. So, it's below zero. Maybe 3 below zero. So, I think the temperature rating on this thing is very good. For the rest, the material on the inside, when you first crawl in it, because you let it lay a little bit before you crawl in it, gets a little bit cold feeling. But I think that's just a synthetic. After you lay in it, it gets warm. So there's not a problem. The rest I can say, it's a warm sleeping bag. Now I don't use any good underlayer. Just use this for the reflection of the heat. And then I use a very thin one. So it fits easy in the backpack. And still I had no problems with that. So I can say I'm satisfied. So goodbye. Thanks for watching.